सो स्टूडेंट्स, हम डिस्कस कर रहे थे प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हीडॉल्स। हमने तीन मेथड्स डिस्कस किए हैं। आज के मेथड में हम इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हीडॉल डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं। फर्स्ट मेथड है फ्रॉम हेलो एरीन्स। दिस इज इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हीडॉल्स। नाउ दिस इज कॉल्ड डाउज प्रोसेस। इन दिस मेथड हेलोएरीन इज ट्रीटेड विद, दिस इज आवर हेलोएरीन, इट इज ट्रीटेड विद फ्यूज्ड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, वी गेट फिनॉल। द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द रिएक्शन इज फिनॉल। नाउ सी, दिस रिएक्शन इज कैरीड आउट अंडर ड्रास्टिक कंडीशन एट अ टेम्परेचर ऑफ 623 केल्विन and at a pressure of approximately 300 atmospheres atm. Now see why drastic conditions are required. We have already explained in the reactions of haloarenes that haloarenes cannot undergo SN1 reaction under normal conditions. They cannot undergo SN2 reactions under normal conditions. Why not SN1? Why not SN2? I have discussed it, because this bond strength is more, therefore it cannot break, because pi system of benzene ring is rich, it cannot attack. Now the explanation is there. That's why we require here drastic conditions. That's why high temperature and high pressure is required. Now see, what is the mechanism of this reaction? Mechanism of this reaction is interesting. We have haloarene, हमारे पास में haloarene है और इसका हम base से treat करते हैं। Sodium hydroxide is a base. Base का काम होता है abstract hydrogen atom करना। Now यहाँ पे हमारे पास hydrogen atom है, base इस hydrogen को abstract करेगी और resulting in the formation of triple bond। यहाँ से chlorine leaving group भी अच्छा है, यह निकलेगा। यहाँ से हमारे पास में एक intermediate बन जाएगा, this intermediate is called benzyne. Now this is called benzyne. This is very important intermediate. This is called benzyne. Now in the next setup, this benzyne reacts with. Next setup, benzyne reacts with. In the step second, this benzyne reacts with sodium hydroxide. Excess of sodium hydroxide. This is a benzyne. It reacts with excess of sodium hydroxide. Now excess of sodium hydroxide, when we have sodium hydroxide in excess, we have NaOH, they can undergo loss of water, resulting in the formation of NaO-. Therefore here we can have ONa or NaO-. This NaO- can attack over here because this bond may break over here. Therefore this becomes positively charged, we get sodium salt of phenoxide. ONa, O negative, Na plus, this is salt, double bond, and we have negative charge over here. This negative charge abstracts proton. Organic chemistry में प्रोटॉनों की कमी नहीं होती है. It abstracts proton, results in the formation of sodium salt of phenoxide. Now this sodium salt of phenoxide, we treat it with HCl, for example, H positive, Cl negative. Now what happens, this oxygen is protonated, we get phenol, and this sodium, it forms sodium chloride. This is the mechanism of the reaction. Now let us take one more method, that is preparation of phenols from cumene. Now what is this cumene? It is nothing. We have benzene ring, and to this benzene ring attached over here is isopropyl group. This is isopropyl group, CH3CH3CH. I may write it like this. This is cumene. How can we obtain this cumene? This cumene can be obtained by reacting benzene with CH3 C2 Cl in presence of AlCl3, then we can get this cube. Now see this Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Here we get a carbocation, and that carbocation gets rearranged to form secondary carbocation, and that attacks this benzene, we get cumene. Now this cumene is treated with hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, or any other peroxide. Peroxides are the compounds which contain HOOH linkage, OO linkage, not HOO, which contain OO linkage, sorry. Peroxides are the compounds which contain OO linkage. For example, this is hydrogen peroxide. Now if we take this hydrogen peroxide, we break this bond towards here, we get OOH. Now this peroxide involves two oxygen atoms. These oxygen atoms, this OH group, it's introduced in between this carbon and hydrogen bond. Means insertion reaction will take place over here. This is an insertion reaction. CH3OOH. This is insertion reaction. This OOH is inserted over here. This is insertion reaction. Now this intermediate, this is cumene hydroperoxide intermediate. This is cumene hydroperoxide intermediate. Now this cumene hydroperoxide undergoes Hack rearrangement. Hawk rearrangement. Not Hack, Hawk rearrangement. Hack is different. It undergoes Hawk rearrangement. Now how the Hawk rearrangement takes place? This bond breaks. If this bond breaks towards this side, we get C double bond O. And to this C double bond O, we have attached methyl and methyl group, CH3 and CH3. Now what happens, if the bond breaks, this becomes positively charged. OH negative attacks this positive charge, we get phenol. Plus, we get phenol. This is how we can prepare phenol from cumene. First, we form cumene. By Friedel-Crafts reaction, this is Friedel-Crafts reaction. Then from cumene, we treated with hydrogen peroxide for cumene hydroperoxide. Then this undergoes Hawk rearrangement. Then we form what? This phenol. Now two questions have been asked in continuously last 2 years from this. The question was, if you treat benzene with this, you get a compound A. This was your compound A. And this compound, upon treatment with hydrogen peroxide, it gives two products B and C. This was product B and C. One more question was formed. What is the intermediate in when we prepare phenol from cumene? This is the intermediate. Now these were two questions which were asked from this concept. Now this was all about preparation of phenols. Now let us understand properties of phenols. Let us try to discuss properties of phenols. Now this is phenol. See, this phenol contains OH bond. This phenol contains OH bond. It's a OH bond. This bond is a polar bond. We can break this bond towards oxygen atom. We have to see what type of reactions can phenol show. We can break this bond towards oxygen atom. If we break this bond towards oxygen atom, we get a negative charge on phenol. This is called phenoxide ion. This is called phenoxide ion. Now this is called a phenoxide ion. This phenoxide ion is formed plus we get H positive. This is a reversible reaction. Means we can cleave this bond. If we cleave this bond, H positive is released. If H positive is released, therefore this shows acidic nature. Means phenol can show all reactions because of cleavage of this bond. Which acid show? Acidic nature. Now acids react with metals. Phenol can react with metals to form ONA, OLI, OK. It can react with bases. It can react with bases. Phenol, because of this acidic hydrogen, it can react with bases. It can react with metal carbonates because acids react with metal carbonates. Acids react with metal sulfonates. Metal sulfates, it can react with metal sulfates like that. Now this is acidic nature of phenols. Now we have to understand here, how much acidic are these phenols? Are they more acidic than alcohols? Now we will discuss first here then the first property, that is acidic nature. Now why phenols are acidic? Because bond between oxygen and hydrogen is polar, they can give H positive ion in aqueous solution. Now phenols are acidic in nature because they ionize to give H positive ion in aqueous solution, means in water they ionize to give H positive ions. Now let us take side by side alcohol C2H5OH. Now if it dissociates, it gives C2H5O negative plus H positive aqueous. Now see, in this case, this is anion. The anion formant, it's called alkoxide ion. Here it's called phenoxide ion. The anion formant, if this anion is stable, then more of it will be formed. Main ye kehna chahta hu, agar ye anion zyada stable hai, to zyada zyada banegi. Agar ye zyada zyada anion formation ho gaya, to zyada H positive ion niklega, kyunki forward reaction hoga. Agar H positive ion zyada niklega, to kya hoga? तो फिनॉल ज्यादा डिसोसिएट होगा, तो फिनॉल ज्यादा एसिटिक होगा. नाउ ऑन व्हाट फैक्टर इट विल डिपेंड, हाउ मच एच पॉजिटिव आयन विल बी फॉर्मड, हाउ मच द रिएक्शन विल प्रोसीड इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. इट विल डिपेंड अपॉन द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस एनायन, मीन्स द एसिडिक नेचर डिपेंड्स अपॉन स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ एनायन फॉर्मड. द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ एनायन ओवर हियर, द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ एनायन ओवर हियर. इफ वी चेक द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस फिनॉक्साइड आयन, दिस इज अ फिनॉक्साइड आयन, इफ वी चेक इट्स स्टेबिलिटी, this is phenoxide ion. Now see, this double bond we can shift over here, negative charge over here, double bond over here, we can get a resonance structure. This is negative charge, double bond O, double bond, double bond. We can have one more resonating structure, we can get double bond over here, this is double bond, and this is negative charge, this is double bond, double bond O. We can get one more structure over here, shifting of this bond. This is negative charge, double bond O, double bond, double bond, and we can have original structure back. These are resonance structures. The greater the resonating structure is, more is the stability of the species. Hence, this phenoxide ion is resonance stabilizer. It's more stable. It is more stable. It is stabilized by resonance. If it is more stable, more of it will be formed. If more of it will be formed, to zyada H positive ion niklega. Agar zyada H positive ion niklega, तो ज्यादा एसिडिक होगा, क्योंकि एरिनस कॉन्सेप्ट के हिसाब से जो भी स्पेशी एच पॉजिटिव आयन इन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन में रहेगी उतनी ज्यादा एसिडिक होगी, देयरफॉर ये ज्यादा एसिडिक हो, फिनॉल इज मोर एसिडिक. नाउ सी इन की इन दिस केस, दिस अल्कोक्साइड आयन, इट इज नॉट रेजोनेंस स्टेबलाइजर, इट इज नॉट रेजोनेंस स्टेबलाइजर. इफ इट इज नॉट रेजोनेंस स्टेबलाइजर, देयरफॉर इट इज नॉट स्टेबल. इफ इट इज नॉट स्टेबल, लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ एच पॉजिटिव इज फॉर्मड. इफ ओनली लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ एच पॉजिटिव आयन इज फॉर्मड, therefore this bond breaks very slowly. If this bond does not break, therefore they are less acidic. Now we have come to the conclusion that phenols are more acidic than alcohols. Why? Because the phenoxide ion formant is resonance stabilized, and the alkoxide ion formant on the other hand is not stabilized by any effector nor by resonance. Now number second factor, we determine this acidic nature. We determine it in terms of pKa. मैंने आपको कहा था pKa is inversely proportional to Ka. जितना ज्यादा Ka होगा, K is the ionization constant. Means जितना ज्यादा ionize होगा उतना Ka ज्यादा होगा. जितना ज्यादा ionize होगा उतना H positive ज्यादा निकलेगा. जितना ज्यादा Ka होगा उतना acidic nature ज्यादा होगा. तो क्यों हम pKa का यूज करते हैं, Ka का नहीं करते हैं? के वैल्यूज इतनी ज्यादा आती है, दे आर डिफिकल्ट टू मैनिपुलेट, दैट्स व्हाई वी डिटरमाइन इन टर्म्स ऑफ pKa. जितना Ka ज्यादा होगा उतना एसिडिक नेचर ज्यादा होगा, और जितना Ka ज्यादा होगा उतना pKa कम होगा. मीन्स लेस द pKa, मोर इज Ka, मोर इज एसिडिक नेचर. तो क्या करना है, सिंस फिनॉल्स आर मोर एसिडिक, उनका pKa ज्यादा कम होना चाहिए देन अल्कोहल्स. pKa वैल्यू ऑफ फिनॉल्स इज लेस देन दैट ऑफ अल्कोहल्स. pKa value of phenols is less than alcohols. जिसका भी pKa value कम होगा वो ज्यादा acidic होगा. जिस भी species का pKa value कम होगा वो ज्यादा acidic होगा. For example, let us take two compounds over here. This is phenol, and let us take one more compound. This is cyclohexanol. Tell me, this is alcohol and this is phenol. Iska pKa value 9 approximately hai, aur iska 18 अप्रोक्सीमेटली है pKa। अब मुझे आप बता दो कि कौन सा कंपाउंड ज्यादा एसिडिक है जिसका pKa वैल्यू कम है। इफ दिस कंपाउंड इज ए दिस इज बी देन दिस इज मोर एसिडिक देन दिस ए इज मोर एसिडिक देन बी। एंड नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी दी फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग एसिडिक नेचर ऑफ फिनॉल्स। अगर इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग ग्रुप होगा तो क्या होगा, अगर इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप होगा तो क्या होगा, एसिडिक नेचर पे कौन सा असर पड़ेगा। नाउ यहाँ पे आपको बोर्ड में क्वेश्चन आता है व्हाई फिनॉल्स आर मोर एसिडिक देन अल्कोहल्स। तो आपको क्या लिखना है, फिनॉल्स आर मोर एसिडिक देन अल्कोहल्स बिकॉज ऑफ फॉलोइंग रीजंस। नंबर फर्स्ट, इन केस ऑफ फिनॉल्स द फिनॉक्साइड आयन फॉर्मेट इज रेजोनेंस स्टेबलाइज्ड एज कम्पेयर टू दैट ऑफ द अल्कोहल्स व्हाइल इट इज नॉट स्टेबलाइज्ड एट ऑल। नंबर सेकंड, pKa वैल्यू ऑफ फिनॉल्स इज लेस एज कम्पेयर टू द pKa वैल्यू ऑफ अल्कोहल्स। स्मॉलर द pKa वैल्यू मोर इज एसिडिक नेचर दैट्स व्हाई अल्कोहल्स फिनॉल्स आर मोर एसिडिक देन दैट ऑफ अल्कोहल्स। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस लेक्चर।